Hello, my name is Alec Hebert, and I was a designer on this project that we're going to look at here today, Luminaria. Luminaria was a freshman project at DigiPen Institute of Technology. It had five designers on it, including myself, and I was the lead designer on the project. So I designed every level that we're going to take a look at here today and came up with a lot of the mechanics. So the object of the game is it's a puzzle game, so you want to get the light from this emitter down into this receiver. And you do this by reflecting it with these mirrors here. And the levels become steadily more complicated as time goes on. So a lot of what I did when designing these puzzles is this was my first experience really working on a team project for a game. It was our freshman project, and so I was kind of pioneering my own ideas for how to design levels, but one of the things that I found worked for me was create a puzzle that is impossible to solve, and then come up with tools that I would want to solve that puzzle. And these tools could be things that we already had in the game, or this could also be the basis for, you know, coming up with a new fun gameplay mechanic. So that was how a lot of the game mechanics in the game were birthed. Was we came up with impossible puzzles and then attempted to solve them. So one of the new mechanics that we came up with is this dust cloud right here that you see. So you see the light is starting off going into the receiver, but it's dimmed by the dust. So we need to get around the dust so that it is bright enough to actually activate the receiver. And you can hear the sound effects influencing the music and everything. So we had a sound designer named Will Tinoco on the team. Did a really good job with the dynamic soundtrack. You'll see when I activate this new mechanic here, the lens, we get a whole new track of the music in. And this ended up being one of the really big selling points for our games. And on the subject of impossible puzzles and how to solve them, you would think this puzzle would be impossible until we came up with this mechanic for the lens, which will re-intensify the light after it has passed through dust. So we use that mechanic to solve this puzzle. One of the big things that we wanted to push was having as few words in our tutorials as possible. We wanted to recreate the magic of Portal, I guess, as freshmen. But the idea was that we would create levels that could teach the player how to play rather than explaining it to them outright, and it worked out really, really well for us. This mechanic here, you see, we've got different colored receivers now. This one is blue, but it's receiving red, and this one is vice versa. So this is a nice way to introduce this idea and let you sort of teach yourself, which is always more satisfying. So I'm going to jump to one of the later levels in the game just to show you before I end this video. Here's a puzzle. So this is when things start getting more and more complex. We have these things over here, which are prisms. They will split the light into its base colors, which was a wonderful idea from Douglas Wick, our tech lead. And so to solve this puzzle, we have to activate these switches to activate these extra emitters in order to activate all of the receivers in the puzzle. So we can hit all of these at once by splitting the light and bringing this guy down here. Splitting it again. You notice the music is swelling as all the different mechanics come into play. There you have it. Solved puzzle. So this has been Luminaria. I was the lead designer on the project, Al Hebert, and thank you so much for watching.